Come on, evolve already! How much longer do I have to wait? Jeez.
Can I help you with something?
Our teacher told us that humans evolved from apes, so I'm waiting for this gorilla to turn into a human! Huh? Now that would be worth an A!
Mary says she's not planning to turn into anyone. Plenty of bananas as is.
Guess I'm not getting an A. Wait, why aren't you in a cage?
I'm not a usual chimpanzee. I'm from the lab. I work with the university scientists. They test all sorts of new inventions on me.
Wow, what are they testing now?
A time machine. You know what? I will help you. We will go to the past and I will show you how apes became humans.
Awesome! Let's go right now!
Mary wants us to take her to the past too. She says bananas were much tastier back then. But gorillas are so clumsy, what if she breaks something?
No, I promise! I will look after her, please!
Okay, then you're in charge of Mary. Behave yourself. To the lab, my friends! Alright, the destination is Africa, 10 million years ago.
10 million? Even my great-grandpa wasn't born then!
Well, imagine, your great-grandpa was born about 100 years ago, but we're going to meet such a distant ancestor that to call him by his full name, I would have to say great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great for 2 days non-stop. Hold on tight, everybody. Off we go! There he is, your distant ancestor. Proconsul is what we call him.
Hello, Grandpa. We come in peace. I brought you fruits from the future. Hey, I thought you didn't like 21st century bananas. You didn't come here for this.
See? Proconsul is an ape. An ancient ape. But he's not like me.
Are there proconsuls in the 21st century too?
Sure. As skeletons in a museum. Well, don't worry, kid. They didn't go extinct. Their descendants have just changed a lot. Mary does not understand why monkeys have to change if the forest is such a paradise, with plenty of food. Mary, come back now. It can be very dangerous here. You should have listened. It's a saber-toothed tiger, run! Let's get home quickly.
Mary, come on! Grandpa, watch out!
Mary, there should be a red accelerator lever next to you. Pull it! Mary, come on!
Where are we? I mean, when are we?
Looks like without an accelerator we didn't reach 21st century. We're still in Africa, but this time, 4 million years ago. See, Mary, life in the forest is good, but nothing lasts forever. A few million years have passed. Africa became too dry, and the forests thinned. Trees became scarce.
What happened to the proconsul?
Don't worry about him. Worry about his numerous great-great-great children. It's their time we're in now. And there's one of them. The one who stayed in the forest.
He's got such long hands.
Yes, he needs those to climb skillfully. His eyes are sharp to see fruits from afar. He can stand up for himself with big jaws and teeth. Life has changed and so did the monkeys. But this took millions of years.
So that's what you're like, Grandpa?
No, he's not your grandpa. He is my grandpa.
And where's my grandpa?
Here he is, I think. Don't mess with him. This is a descendant of those apes who risked to climb down, to go into the savannah. They had to do this because there was not enough forest for everybody. As you can see, life under these new conditions has changed them a lot. Get it, Andrew? Through millions of years, some ancient apes evolved into you, humans, and some into us, chimpanzees. Wait, where's Mary? Look at that! Life in the savannah has taught your ancestor to push back the predators. He gained one thing that neither sharp teeth nor sharp claws can replace, a sharp mind. And we need to go home.
For me?
Take it, who knows, maybe it'll come in useful in the 21st century.
I'm getting an A for sure with these photos. I think I get it. Why not all the apes evolved into humans? Some of them turned into you, Charlie. Others into you, Mary. That's what's called evolution.
Exactly, my friend. It just happened really slowly. Kid, you shouldn't evolve backwards in time.